BRICS summit in China. For the first time, Pakistan-based terror groups like Jaish-e-Mohammed and Lashkar-e-Toiba have been named in a joint declaration. That, of course, includes China, an all-weather ally of Pakistan. On Tuesday, Prime Minister Modi will meet President Xi Jinping of China for the first time after the Doklam standoff was resolved.
A significant diplomatic win for India, as BRICS countries for the first time named Pakistan-based terror groups in the joint declaration at the summit in China. While talking about violence in Afghanistan, it says, "We express concern on the violence caused by the Taliban, ISIL, Al-Qaeda, the Haqqani Network, Lashkar-e-Taiba, Jaish-e-Mohammed."
For the first time, you would notice that there has been such a specific listing of terrorist organizations.
Ironically, while the Jaish has been named in the declaration, China has repeatedly blocked any effort at the UN to designate the Jaish chief Masood Azhar a terrorist. The 43-page declaration, which does not name Pakistan, makes a strong reference, however, to the need for states to act against terror, saying, "We deplore all terrorist attacks worldwide, including attacks in BRICS countries. We reaffirm that those responsible for committing, organizing or supporting terrorist acts must be held accountable." Getting China in China to issue a statement on Pakistan-based terror groups is significant, especially since they opposed the same at the BRICS summit last year. But while this is a first for BRICS, the fact is that at the Heart of Asia conference on Afghanistan in December last year, there was a very similar reference made to Pakistan-based terror groups. There too, the Lashkar and Jaish were named, and Pakistan and China, who were present, were both on board. The Prime Minister also offered to host a conference on countering radicalization at the BRICS summit today.
Increasingly, there is a realization that you cannot have double standards in tackling this scourge. You cannot have good and bad terrorists.
The Jaish-e-Mohammed was banned way back in 2001 by the UN. But China has all these years made a distinction between the group and its chief, Masood Azhar, who it refuses to acknowledge as a terrorist. Will Beijing change its stand now? That is anyone's guess. Nidhi Razdan for NDTV.